Pogacar's last race before the Tour de France, his first race since his wrist injury. You can see we've got Slovenian national champs ahead of us. And it's not the most insightful race, I'm not going to lie, but we do get to see him go nuclear at the end, which is kind of interesting to see. So anyway, he was in the early break. It kind of split up quite early. It seemed hard to know as there wasn't too much TV coverage. But we see Pogacar here with Luka Mezgets, and they were like 65k to go just off the front. And the reason I thought it's kind of interesting to see this video is that, like, he's obviously in good condition. Slovenian national champs is not a, like, easy race to win. It's probably not the hardest, but Mezgets, Mohoric, you know, they're solid riders, so it's not easy to beat them, and you definitely have to be in good condition. So I think you can already see this, as well as his time trial performance, that he's definitely in good condition, and definitely not going to be going there for like a top 10. It's definitely like he'll be competing for the win, would be my opinion. The question is, will he have the depth of 3 weeks? That's going to be interesting. UAE said, oh, well, it's okay because, you know, he was going to have an off season. He's going to have a mid-season break now, which is true, but he obviously won't have trained as much as he would have done if he hadn't broken his wrist. Here's the chasing duo from Bahrain Victorious. So anyway, I would say it probably will be tough for him to win because, you know, the course, okay, it doesn't have much time trialing, but it doesn't suit, you know, either Vingegaard or Pogacar much more. I'd say it's pretty even on that sense. But what I would say is that, like, Vingegaard was very good last year. Okay, it was like two mountain stages he put all his time in, but nonetheless, Vingegaard looks good this year. Pogacar doesn't look as good. Obviously, he had an unreal classic season. But what you could say is that, like, from his wrist injury, that's definitely going to hinder his preparation for the Tour de France. So I think it would be natural to think that he will not be in as good form. However, having said that, you know, people are good at training these days. It's not like you need loads of races. But I do think only having one race before the Tour could be tough, especially with a really hard opening, like 3-4 days in the Basque Country, where it's definitely not a soft tap. And they also go to the Pyrenees early. But anyway, getting to the end of the race, and it's 2 kilometers to go. It's an uphill finish. Here, apparently, Mezgets and Pogacar were saying, do you want to get silver? Because your girlfriend got silver as well. And Pogacar said, nah, you're all right, King. I want the win. And Mezgets was like, oil. And that was basically it, because it was an uphill finish. And to be honest, Mezgets on his best day maybe could have won this, to be honest. You know, well, not won it, but he could have competed a bit more. Like, he is pretty strong. If I was Mezgets, I wouldn't have pulled at all. They had a 3:50. I just refused to pull and go, Pogacar, this is yours to win. I'm going to sit on because this uphill finish suits him so much. And I don't really know why he did as much work as he did, to be honest. I think it would have been wise to really sit on from quite far out to us because the gap was fat. And even if Mohoric and Govekar come back, it doesn't actually make a massive difference. I would say, to be honest, he should have sat on quite a lot. I really wouldn't have worked. Second place, it doesn't mean much for Mezgets. I'm pretty sure he's already won this race, so yeah, I think probably not tactically the wisest decision. And you can see Pogacar starts to wind it up. Mezgets is like trying mega hard to hold his wheel. But at the end of the day, when Pogacar goes bim-bam on climbs like this, not many people can stay with him. Especially with, like, if you've just been training pulls with him, Pogacar's going to be more aero than Mezgets as well. So he's not going to have much draft. So it'll be a tough day out. But you can see here, like, he looks pretty good. Like, it's hard to really say. Obviously, he's like dropped a sprinter, Chow, obviously. But again, it's more kind of just speculation. Like, is he going to go the TT? Everyone's like, always quicker than last time. But then you think about it, it's like the air pressure, the wind can change. The people believe, be it, like, they race my level. They were like, the lad who came second was like Tour of Serbia last year, 20th overall. Like, you know, that's, you know, if it's not surprising he beats him by 5 minutes. Like, if he didn't, that'd be kind of worrying. So again, it's so far, it's quite hard to really tell. Having said that, if you hadn't won, you'd be big panic. So far, you kind of think, yeah, he is in good condition. I think his wrist was interesting. He said that, like, he definitely can't crash on his wrist, which is always interesting psychologically. Like, you really might not take as much risk. I don't know how much that will actually pay a point, will matter when he's actually racing. But he still has, like, a wrist strap on it, which I guess can't be great, but probably not a massive issue, to be honest. I mean, it's not like you're going to use your wrist too much except out the saddle, so probably okay. Mezgets has given up. He knows no chance of getting the W. But here again, Pogacar looks pretty good on this steep gradient. Like, he does look like he's motoring. Just from the visuals, he's definitely not, you know, not in terrible condition. Decent crowds as well. But anyway, yeah, Pogacar basically just solos from the win from here. So anyway, cheers for watching. Hope you did enjoy. And I'll see you with some more national champs vids in the future.
Je to prvi kolesar sveta Tadej Pogačar, ki je Vsaj na pogled res zlahka opravil s konkurenco in je lahko nad vse zadovoljen s svojo pripravo.
Res posem prepričljivo, še zadnji zavoj, tule je že posem popustil, veda, tule tvegati ne sme več, previdno ta zadnji zavoj in pa samo še ciljna ravnina.
Test pred največjim ciljem sezone, pred dirko po Franciji je opravljen. Tadej Pogačar že daleč pred ciljno črto slavi naslov prvaka. V naslednjem letu se bo ponašal z majico, s slovensko zastavo, zadovoljen, pozdravlja gledalce in se veseli. Tadej Pogačar je državni prvak z letnico 2023. Čestitke.